Hello and welcome to this new Clavister how-to. Today we are going to see how we can implement a configuration useful mainly for small business or home office environments, which can anyhow fit to larger installations whenever we need to make a group of firewall interfaces behaving as a layer 2 switch. We need first to identify which interfaces we want to use in our switch set, and therefore we are going to group them together inside an interface group. It is common to use such configuration on LAN side, so let's call this interface group LAN Zone. We use here a couple of interfaces, G5 and G6, but of course more interfaces can be grouped. We define now the IP parameters that we want to use on our LAN zone, that are IP and subnet mask. Usually, LAN interfaces are also provided with a DHCP server to dynamically assign clients with their IP configuration, so we also had an address pool to be used later for DHCP server setup. Let's add then a DHCP server to our LAN zone. The DHCP server will release addresses from the LAN zone pool to clients connected to LAN zone interfaces. We can also set additional parameters to be leased, such as a default gateway and a couple of DNS servers. We are going now to activate a transparent mode for all the interfaces belonging to the LAN zone interface group. We need to enter one by one the interface configuration section, assign it with the LAN zone IP and network, and select the Enable Transparent Mode option. Note that DHCP pass-through option should not be enabled if the firewall itself needs to reply to DHCP requests. DHCP requests do not have to be passed through, but they have to be processed by the DHCP server listening on LAN zone. A modification on routing table is also needed. The transparent mode makes the interface working at layer 2. As we can see, interfaces IP routes have been substituted by switch routes. Since here we need the firewall to act as default gateway for the LAN zone, as well as to manage DHCP requests, we have to co-route the LAN zone IP. Also, we need to proxy ARP the same address on LAN zone. This enables the firewall to reply to ARP requests from client on LAN zone that wants to resolve the LAN zone IP. Such route core is also necessary if we want to assess the firewall management interfaces from LAN zone. To allow traffic through the firewall, IP policies must be configured accordingly. We can create new policies or modify the existing policies. Note that the LAN interface group is going to be used in place of the single interface originally used for the policies. Setup has been now completed, hence we can deploy the configuration. We can now verify our configuration from a PC connected to a port belonging to the LAN zone group. We can see that the DHCP server has released an IP address to the client. The client is able to ping the firewall IP address, as well as another host inside the same switch group. We can open the firewall web user interface. And finally, we can browse the internet.